Welcome to the Astrology of the San Francisco Giants. My name is Cesar. I am the author of Baseball and Astrological Sightline. I am also a Giants fan. The game of baseball has deep roots in San Francisco. And it has deep roots in the soil of North America. Native American tribes played a game in which a ball was hit with a bat. In Mexico, the sacred ball game also involved a ball being hit with a bat. Games like these have long been played all over the world. They have been played for thousands of years in Africa, Europe, and Asia. These games were fertility rituals. Our national pastime derives from these fertility rituals. These rituals and games were even performed in ancient Egypt. Here is a depiction from the tomb of a pharaoh of a ball being hit with a bat. In ancient Egypt, games like baseball were symbolic reenactments of the conflict between two feuding gods, Osiris and Seth. Osiris was a god of abundance and vegetation, whereas Seth was a god of barrenness who ruled over winter. Seth would kill Osiris, which brought times of winter. But Osiris would come back to life, bringing back spring and bringing back the plants and the grass. Rituals like baseball were performed in the season of spring to make sure that Osiris would be resurrected and to make sure that spring would indeed return. In games of baseball, a symbolic battle is being performed. On one side is the season of winter and all of the hardships it brings, including cold, hunger, and death. On the other side is the season of spring, with the abundance it brings and its reaffirmation of life. These symbolic conflicts between winter and spring, between death and life, are also present in the holiday of Easter, which commemorates the death and resurrection of Jesus. Jesus dies as things do in winter and returns to life as things do in spring. Easter also celebrates the end of winter and the return of spring. The holiday of Easter is held very near to baseball's opening day. Another legend of Easter is a rabbit that hides eggs. In German culture, this rabbit was an animal special to their goddess of spring, the goddess Ostara, for whom Easter is named. These eggs are a symbol of life. They are hidden by a rabbit. They are found by children, but they will need to be fertilized. These eggs will be fertilized through a ritual. A ritual that is a game, a ball game, in which a ball is symbolic of both an egg and a seed. A ball game in which a ball makes contact with a bat, a phallic object symbolic of the energy of fathers. A ball game in which a ball makes contact with a glove, a vaginal symbol symbolic of the energy of mothers. together. The bat and the glove will fertilize the egg, bringing procreation and abundance. The crops will grow, the animals will thrive, babies will be born, children will be healthy. The sky, the stars, and the planets are also part of our game. Each position of a baseball team is an embodiment of a sign of the zodiac and the energy of a planet. The sign of Aries and the planet Mars correspond to the shortstop. A shortstop requires quick bursts of energy. The ram, the animal symbol of Aries, charges towards its target, crashing against it with head and horns. A shortstop often charges ram-like toward the ball. When fielding a slow grounder, the shortstop must run forward to confront the ball. This play exemplifies Aries' energy, charging forward, unrestrained. The sign of Taurus and the planet Venus correspond to the center fielder. Center field carries a special mystique. This is because it is the position whose energy is closest to the sensibility of the game. Taurus is the sign of plants and vegetation. The center fielder stands with a wide expanse of green to one's right and to one's left. Baseball is a game tied to both land and nature. Taurus is a sign of fertility. In the grass of center field, we witness the renewal of spring and the life-affirming nature of the game. The sign of Gemini and the planet Mercury are embodied in the pitcher. Gemini is a mental sign. In battle, a Gemini's best weapon is one's ability to cleverly outsmart an opponent. The pitcher engages in a mental as well as physical battle with the batter. The pitcher's intent is to outsmart the batter by throwing the ball by him, with a variety of trajectories, velocities, and placements. The sign of Cancer and the moon correspond to the catcher. The symbol for Cancer is the crab. A catcher wears a chest protector, shin guards, and a mask, equipment that is shell-like and reminiscent of a crab. Cancer is the sign of home and domesticity. A catcher's perch is home plate. With his Cancerian protective and defensive instincts, a catcher guards home plate against hostile invaders from the opposing team. As Cancer is a mother and a nurturer, the catcher is a nurturer to the pitcher. When a pitcher becomes anxious, the catcher will walk to the mound to soothe the pitcher. The sign of Leo and the sun are represented by the right fielder. Right field is usually the sunniest part of the baseball field, and right fielders are sunny, extroverted personalities who love to shine. Right fielders love attention, and they know what to do with it. The sign Virgo, like the sign Gemini, corresponds to the pitcher. Both Virgo and Gemini are ruled by the planet Mercury. Virgo is the sign of the analytical mind. Virgo is also the sign of work. The pitcher in Virgo mode is a laborer. The pitcher exerts more physical and mental energy than does any other player on the field. As a laborer engages himself in the object of his labor, the pitcher is the player most focused on the game. The pitcher must concentrate if the job is to be performed effectively. As a Virgo strives for perfection, a Virgo pitcher will refine his control. Virgo pitchers are finesse pitchers, more so than are Gemini pitchers who rely on velocity. Virgo pitchers are the nibblers who slice the corners of the plate. The sign of Libra and the planet Venus correspond to the second baseman. The symbol of Libra is the scale. Libras are adept at matters that require balance. The second baseman's quintessential act is the performance of the double play. The double play is performed at its most spectacular when the second baseman avoids the runner by leaping straight into the air. From the air, with one's feet off the ground, the second baseman throws the ball to first base, putting out the runner, completing the play. This act requires a highly refined Libran equilibrium. The sign of Scorpio and the planet Pluto are embodied in the third baseman. The ball is hit to the third baseman quickly and with tremendous force, especially when a right-handed batter pulls the ball. The ball also advances toward the third baseman from a shorter distance than it does to the shortstop or the second baseman. The third baseman does not have a large area of ground to cover, but he must react very quickly because of the speed of the ball passing through his territory. The quick reactions of the third baseman originate from the intense concentration for which third baseman and Scorpios are known. One gets in position to receive the impact of the batted ball. Scorpio is a fixed sign. A Scorpio is stationary, yet poised, alert, and waiting. The third baseman becomes set and waits for the ball. One receives the blow of the ball and rapidly returns it, firing it back, putting out the runner. The sign of Sagittarius and the planet Jupiter correspond to the batter. Like an archer pulling a bow to shoot an arrow, the batter swings his bat. The centaur shoots an arrow, aiming, aspiring for a star. The batter swings a bat at a ball, aiming, aspiring to hit the ball to an auspicious location. Once he hits the ball, a journey begins. The hope and optimism of Sagittarius are present in the batter. His fans and teammates hope that the at-bat of each player will prove fortunate and lead to a run. Capricorn and the planet Saturn are embodied in the manager. The sign of Capricorn has the qualities of age, wisdom, and decisiveness. Capricorn corresponds to the manager who makes the decisions. The manager sets the lineups, makes the pitching changes, and calls for the pinch hitters. The sign of Aquarius and the planet Uranus correspond with the left fielder. The mind of an Aquarius strives to be objective and detached. Aquarius is the sign most able to see the big picture. The left fielder needs this ability to track the trajectory of an object in flight. One is assisted by a capacity to sense air currents affecting the flight of the ball. Aquarius and the planet Uranus also correspond with the home run. The arc of a home run, a ball hit a long distance and over a fence, has the Aquarian quality of air travel. Like the sign of Aquarius, a home run is fixed and solid, high and all-encompassing. Hank Aaron and Babe Ruth both have the sun in Aquarius. Barry Bonds has the moon in Aquarius. The sign of Pisces and the planet Neptune correspond with the first baseman. Pisces is a receptive water sign. A Pisces absorbs emotional and psychic vibrations. Similarly, a first baseman's primary function is to receive and absorb. The first baseman receives the throws of the other infielders that put out runners. This requires a receptive ability to gather and absorb all manner of throws. Errant throws will skid in the dirt, fly overhead, or straight to the side. The first baseman, like a fisherman with a large net, is ready to catch them all. The symbol of Pisces is the fish. The first baseman's mitt has a distinct rounded edge that makes it resemble the gill of a fish. Gills are unique to fishes, the animal symbol of Pisces. Each Major League Baseball team has an astrological birth chart cast for the moment it was born. This birth chart reveals the tendencies and fortunes of the team, including its strengths and weaknesses at every position. The Giants franchise was born in New York on December 7, 1882. My rectifications show their time of birth to have been 1:36 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. This is the astrological birth chart of the Giants, cast for New York City. A rare and unusual feature in the birth chart of the Giants is a conjunction of four planets in the sign of Sagittarius: Mercury, Venus, Mars, and the Sun. And Jupiter, the ruling planet of Sagittarius, is in a very strong aspect to the planet Uranus. The energy of Sagittarius is very prominent in the Giants chart. Sagittarius is the sign of the batter. Historically, the Giants have been a team of strong bats. Across the street from Oracle Park, there is a statue of a centaur holding a bat and ready to swing. Giants first baseman Roger Connor was one of the few power hitters of the 1880s. In the decade of the 1880s, Roger Connor hit 136 home runs, the most by any player in the 1880s. First baseman Bill Terry was the last National League hitter to bat over 400 when he batted 401 in 1930. Mel Ott held the National League record for home runs for many years with 511. In New York, the Giants' home field was called the Polo Grounds. Polo is a Sagittarian game, a game played on horses. John McGraw became the Giants manager in 1902. He would lead the Giants for 30 years. These 30 years, he was the face of the Giants franchise. When one thought of the Giants, one thought of McGraw. John McGraw's birth chart shows he was born to be the face of the New York Giants. His Sun and Mercury in the sign of Aries are conjunct the Aries ascendant of the New York Giants. The New York Giants birth chart also has Saturn in the first house of outward personality and appearance, which made the manager the most visible member of the team. With an ascendant in the fiery sign of Aries, the New York Giants had an aggressive style. They often provoked brawls. With Saturn in the first house, the ringleader was obviously their manager. Another intense aspect in the Giants' birth chart is the opposition between Saturn and the Moon. The Moon represents the players as a collective whole, as a family of brothers. Saturn, meanwhile, is more than a manager. Saturn is a father figure and a disciplinarian. The Giants Moon is in the sign of Scorpio. The energy of Scorpio is often threatening and destructive, but once a Scorpio becomes disciplined, once one's powers are harnessed, an amazing transformation takes place. For the Giants, this transformation takes place within the crucible of a Saturn opposition. When John McGraw died, newspaper columnist Hayward Braun had this to say about his influence. An important part of McGraw's capacity for leadership was that he could take kids out of wheat fields and coal mines and make them walk and talk and chatter and play ball with the look of eagles. In astrological symbolism, the eagle is an exaltation of the sign Scorpio, the same way that refined coal becomes a diamond. A refined scorpion becomes an eagle. A scorpion is a lowly creature that dwells in dark places, like a kid in a coal mine. But once refined, it becomes an eagle, a poised and magnificent animal with the power of flight. In 1958, the Giants would leave New York and move to San Francisco. No longer in New York, the Giants shed their rising sign of Aries. Once in San Francisco, the Giants' rising sign became Aquarius. Aquarius, whose symbol is the human being, with all its aspirations, its strivings for knowledge, and its humanistic ideals. Aquarius is also the sign of Giants. Indeed, when someone is described as a giant, it is meant that he or she is the best potential of humanity. A giant is also a rebel. In Greek mythology, the giants were a race of divine beings who battled to overthrow the gods of Mount Olympus. A giant will challenge the established order. The city of San Francisco shares the humanistic values of the sign Aquarius and the rebellious nature of giants. San Francisco is the birthplace of the United Nations, an endeavor to embody the humanistic ideals of peace and brotherhood between nations. Like the city of San Francisco, the giants have long embraced the value of racial and ethnic diversity. Indeed, the giants were the first team to scout the Dominican Republic and the first team to sign multitudes of Latino players. The giants were also the first team to sign a Japanese player when they signed Masanori Murakami in 1964. The sign of Aquarius and its ruling planet Uranus also bring the home run. In 2007, Barry Bonds, a San Francisco giant, would break Hank Aaron's record for career home runs. The birth chart of Barry Bonds has a strong resonance with that of the San Francisco Giants. His moon in Aquarius is conjunct the Giants' ascendant. This is the aspect that led Barry Bonds to be the face of the Giants franchise for many years. The planet Uranus brings technological innovations such as steroids. The birth chart of the Giants has a square aspect between Uranus and the planet Jupiter. A square aspect from Jupiter can cause things to expand beyond their normal limits. Here, it caused an excess of Uranus energy that led San Francisco to become ground zero for baseball's steroid scandal. It would also bring distortion to the meaning of the word giant, now implying someone who amasses muscle mass through unaccepted technologies. Barry Bonds, Mars, and Venus are both in the sign of Gemini, and both are conjunct to the giants Jupiter. Barry's Mars and Venus are also both square to the giants Uranus. It was these aspects that tied the fate of Barry Bonds to the fate of the San Francisco Giants and brought Barry Bonds into center stage of baseball's steroids drama. Among Giants fans, Willie Mays holds a magical aura like no other player. Willie Mays is likely the most beloved giant to play in San Francisco. The birth chart of Willie Mays has a sun in Taurus. This is the placement that makes him a natural center fielder. The sun in Taurus is also conjunct to Neptune in the birth chart of the Giants. This is the aspect that allows Willie Mays to evoke the transcendental love of Neptune from Giants fans.
Believe it. Hold on to that feeling. Steal.
Thank you. If you would like to know more about the astrology of the San Francisco Giants, or if you would like to know about the astrology of any Major League Baseball team, please check out my book, Baseball and Astrological Sightline. It is available online. If you'd like to reach the author, please send me an email. My email address is baseballastrology@outlook.com. Play ball.